Hello everyone, welcome to Himalay IAS class. This is Keshav Sir's IAS Prelims Lens. In this session, we will be discussing modern India questions on freedom struggle. First question, with reference to Raula Satyagraha, which of the following statements are correct? One, the Raula Act was based on the recommendations of the Sedition Committee. Two, in Raula Satyagraha, Gandhiji tried to utilize the Home Rule League. Three, demonstrations against the arrival of Simon Commission coincided with Raula Satyagraha. Select the correct answer. A, 1 only. B, 1 and 2 only. C, 2 and 3 only. D, 1, 2 and 3 only. You know, the Simon Commission was in 1927. So, C is the wrong option. So, if we take out 3 from the answer, we are left with A and B is the option. And both A and B, I mean, statement 1 and statement 2 are correct. Raula Act was based on the recommendations of Sedition Committee. Raula Act is also known as Anarchical Crimes Act. And this Raula Satyagraha started in 1919 and Gandhiji tried to utilize Home Rule League for Raula Satyagraha. So correct answer is B, 1 and 2 only. Next question, Quit India Movement was launched in response to A, Cabinet Mission Plan, B, Cripps Proposals, C, Simon Commission Report, Wavell Plan. So here, the failure of Cripps Mission led to the launching of Quit India Movement. So the correct answer is option B. Cabinet Mission Plan comes after this, 1946. Simon Commission Report was in 1927. So they are not the correct answer. Next question. Annie Besant was 1. Responsible for starting the Home Rule Movement. 2. The founder of Theosophical Society. 3. Once the president of Indian National Congress. Select the correct answer. A, 1 only. B, 2 and 3 only. C, 1 and 3 only. D, 1, 2 and 3 only. Annie Besant was not the founder of Theosophical Society. So that is a wrong option. So the correct answer will be that she was responsible for starting Home Rule League movement in India. She along with Tilak. And she was once the president of Indian National Congress in 1917. So the correct answer will be option C, 1 and 3 only. Next question. During Indian freedom struggle, the National Social Conference was formed. What was the reason for its formation? A, different social reform groups or organizations of Bengal region united to form a single body to discuss the issues of larger interest and to prepare appropriate petitions, representations to the government. B, Indian National Congress did not want to include social reforms in its deliberations and decided to form a separate body for such purpose. C, Bhairamji Malwari and M.G. Ranade decided to bring together all the social reform groups of the country under one reorganization. D, none of the statements A, B, C above are correct. So initially, when Indian National Congress was formed, it did not wish to take the social reforms and they wanted to have a separate body for deliberating on the social issues. Therefore, National Social Conference was formed. So the correct answer is option B. INC didn't want to include social reforms in its deliberations and decided to form a separate body for such a purpose. Next question. The Congress ministries resigned in the seven provinces in 1939 because A, the Congress could not form ministries in other four provinces. B, emergence of a left wing in the Congress made the working of the ministries impossible. C, there were widespread communal disturbances in their provinces. D, none of the statements A, B, C given above are correct. The answer for this is none of the statements A, B, and C are correct, because 1939 was the time when the World War II was going on, and British had decided to make India a participant of World War without asking India's permission and without consulting Indian political parties. So as a mark of protest for this, the Congress ministries had resigned in 1939. Next question. Mahatma Gandhiji undertook fast unto death in 1932 mainly because A, a round table conference failed to satisfy Indian political aspirations. B, Congress and Muslim League had differences of opinion. C, Ramsay MacDonald announced communal award. D, none of the statements A, B, C given above is correct in this context. The correct answer for this, why Mahatma Gandhiji undertook the hunger fast in 1932, is because as opposition to Ramsay MacDonald's communal award, he was afraid if this award comes into reality, then it will divide India into based on communal lines and caste lines. So the correct option is answer C. Next question, consider the following statements. The most effective contribution made by Dadabhai Nauroji to the cause of Indian national movement was that he, one, exposed economic exploitation of India by the British, two, interpreted the ancient Indian text and restored the self-confidence of Indians, three, stressed the need for eradication of all the social evils before anything else. Which of the following statements are correct? So the main contribution of Dadabhai Nauroji was that he exposed the economic exploitation of India by the British, and he had written a book known as Poverty and Un-British Rule in India, critiquing the British policies which led to financial drain of Indian resources. So the correct option would be A, one only. Next question, Rowlatt Act aimed at A, compulsory economic support to war efforts. B, imprisonment without trial and summary procedures for trial. C, suppression of the Khilafat movement. D, imposition of restrictions on freedom of press. So the correct answer for why Rowlatt Act, what it aimed at was that it would imprison people without trial and summary procedures for the trial. So the correct answer is option B. D is about Vernacular Press Act. So that is the wrong option. Next question. Lahore session of the Indian National Congress 1929 is very important in history because one, Congress passed a resolution demanding complete independence. Two, rift between extremists and moderates was resolved in that session. Three, a resolution was passed rejecting the two-nation theory in the session. Select the correct answer, A, one only, B, two and three only, C, one and three only, D, none of the above. Correct answer was in Lahore session 1929, under the leadership presidentship of Jawaharlal Nehru, Congress passed a resolution demanding Purna Swaraj or complete independence. It was celebrated at River Ravi in Lahore, and unfurling of the tricolor flag happened, and the pledge for that was written by Mahatma Gandhiji. Next question. Which one of the following observations is not true about the Quit India movement of 1942? A, it was a non-violent movement. B, it was led by Mahatma Gandhiji. C, it was a spontaneous movement. D, it did not attract the labor class in general. What is not true is option A. Although it was a non-violent movement, there was a lot of violence that took place. Many police stations were burned. But All the other three statements are correct, that Quit India movement was led by Mahatma Gandhiji, was a spontaneous movement, and it did not attract the labor class in general. So that is the correct answer. Next question. What was the purpose with which Sir William Wedderburn and W.S. Kane had set up Indian Parliamentary Committee in 1893? A. To agitate for Indian political reforms in the House of Commons. B. To campaign for the entry of Indians into the imperial judiciary. C. To facilitate a discussion on Indians' independence in the British Parliament. D. To agitate for entry of eminent Indians in the British Parliament. The Indian Parliamentary Committee set up by the British persons like William Wedderburn and Kane was that they wanted to ask for Indian reforms in the House of Commons. So that's the correct answer. Also, William Wedderburn was once the president of Indian National Congress. So we must remember that there is one Britisher who did become the president of Indian National Congress. Next question. Mahatma Gandhiji said that some of his deepest convictions were reflected in a book titled Unto His Last, and the book transformed his life. What was the message from the book that transformed Mahatma Gandhi? A. Uplifting the oppressed and poor is the moral responsibility of an educated man. B. The good of individual is contained in the good of all. C. The life celibacy and spiritual pursuit are essential for noble life. D. All the statements A, B, C given above are correct in this context. Mahatma Gandhiji read a book on John Ruskin, and that unto his last transformed his life because it taught him that the good of an individual is contained in the good of all. So that's the correct option, answer B. Next question. With reference to Indian freedom struggle, Usha Mehta is well known for A. Running the secret Congress radio in the wake of India Quit India movement. B. Participating in the second roundtable conference. C. Leading a contingent of Indian National Army. D. Assisting in the formation of interim government under Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. Usha Mehta is known for the underground activity and running the secret Congress radio in the wake of Quit India movement. Another revolutionary underground activity by a woman was by Aruna Asif Ali Khan in Quit India movement. So correct answer is option A. Next question. With reference to the period of Indian freedom struggle, which of the following were recommended by the Nehru Report? 1. Complete independence for India. 2. Joint electorates for reservation of seats for minorities. 3. Provision of fundamental rights for the people of India in the constitution. Select the correct answer. A. 1 only. B. 2 and 3 only. C. 1 and 3 only. D. 1, 2 and 3 only. See, Nehru Report by Motilal Nehru, it did not talk about complete independence for India. It was asking for dominion status. So if we strike away the statement 1 from the options, the correct answer will be B, 2 and 3 only. Let's look at the CSAT English comprehension question. There is more than a mediocre of truth in the assertion that a working knowledge of ancient history is necessary to the intelligent interpretation of current events. But the sage who uttered these words of wisdom might well have added something on the benefits of studying particularly the famous battles of history for the lessons they contain for those of us who lead or aspire to leadership. Such a study will reveal certain qualities and attributes which enable the winners to win and certain deficiencies which cause the losers to lose. And the student will see that the same pattern recurs consistently again and again throughout the centuries. With reference to the above passage, the following assumptions have been made. 1. A study of the famous battles of history would help us understand the modern warfare. 2. Studying the history is essential for anyone who aspires to be a leader. Which of the following statements are valid? So after reading the options, we need to go back to the passage and read the passage, read the 2-3 summary that we would, lines of summary that we would have made. And so we get to know the answer is both. I'm sorry. The answer is only 2. 2 only is the correct answer for this. It doesn't talk about the modern warfare. So that's all in this session. Thank you.